In today's video, we're going to be talking about the difference between type 1 and type 2 diabetes, and the different treatment methods, including insulin, metformin, and low-carb diets. Both type 1 and type 2 diabetes are characterized by the body not being able to regulate blood sugar efficiently, but the reason behind why this is the case could not be more opposite. So in today's video, we're going to discuss the difference between type 1 and type 2 diabetes, and then we will talk about the effectiveness of different treatment methods. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high-fat, nutrient-dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook where I share new posts every single day. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. For everything from websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform that does it all. Head to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate to start your free trial today. So today we are going to be discussing type 1 and type 2 diabetes. And let's just get straight into it. Type 2 diabetes. We're going to start off today talking about type 2 diabetes because this is the more common of the two. Over 90% of diabetes cases are this type. As I mentioned at the start of this video, being type 2 diabetic means that your body is not managing blood sugar correctly, and this leads to higher blood sugar levels than what is considered normal. Type 2 diabetes is a lifestyle disease and develops after years of being insulin resistant. Insulin is the hormone responsible for keeping our blood sugar within the correct range, and it does this by taking excess sugar out of our blood and transporting it to our cells. However, our cells can start to resist the actions of insulin, which is known as insulin resistance. And basically, this happens as a result of there being too much glucose and not enough room for it. And I have so many videos on my channel talking about insulin resistance, so I won't go too into it today, but if you want to know more, I will link one of those videos up above. We end up getting into this cycle where blood sugar is always rising, mainly as a result of our diet, and then insulin is constantly being pumped out to deal with it. But as the resistance starts, blood sugar remains high for longer than it should, so the body pumps out even more insulin to deal with it. For a while, this excess insulin is enough to keep blood sugar within check and within a healthy range when we measure it. And this is why insulin resistance goes so undiagnosed. Doctors do not routinely test fasting insulin. But eventually, the excess insulin isn't enough, and this is when we will start to see an increase in fasting blood sugar, and you will be diagnosed with prediabetes and then type 2 diabetes. So in summary, type 2 diabetes is a result of too much insulin overwhelming our cells. Type 1 diabetes. And now let's get into type 1 diabetes. Remember at the start when I said type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes were basically opposite? Here's what I meant by that. Whereas type 2 diabetes is caused by too much insulin, type 1 diabetes is caused by not enough insulin. Type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune disease where the body is not able to produce insulin. And without insulin, there is nothing to take the excess sugar from the bloodstream to the cells, so blood sugar remains high. And whereas type 2 diabetes can be reversed with diet and lifestyle change, type 1 diabetes does not have a cure and can only be managed. Treatments. Oftentimes, both type 1 and type 2 diabetes are treated the same way, by the patient injecting insulin. For type 1 diabetics, this makes sense. These individuals' bodies are not capable of producing insulin, and insulin is a vital hormone for human survival. Without it, blood sugar can become dangerously high, which can result in many irreversible side effects, one of which being death. So insulin is absolutely necessary for someone with type 1 diabetes. But where insulin injections don't make as much sense is with type 2 diabetes. Because remember, this is a disease caused by too much insulin. So by adding more insulin, this can work temporarily to bring your blood sugar down, but then it causes the body to become even more resistant to insulin. And the prescribed insulin the person is injecting will have to be increased. And this is why type 2 diabetes is often referred to as a progressive disease. Because by injecting insulin, the problem only gets worse and worse and worse. The truth is that type 2 diabetes is not a progressive disease, and it absolutely can be reversed when you address the root cause, insulin resistance. The other popular treatment method for type 2 diabetes is the drug metformin. Metformin is really interesting because it is a drug that improves insulin sensitivity. A lot of type 2 diabetics do find that they get good results with metformin. They have an easier time managing blood sugar and an easier time losing and maintaining their weight. However, metformin does come with a whole host of other side effects, most of which are not even mentioned when the drug is prescribed. Some examples of which being severe digestive distress, fatigue, hair loss, and low testosterone for men. I do have a whole video on the side effects of metformin and how you can combat some of them using supplements and other methods, which I will link above if you want to know more. But anyways, the point is that metformin is a drug that improves insulin sensitivity and in turn improves type 2 diabetes. But if there was a way to improve insulin sensitivity naturally, wouldn't that be preferable? Well, it is possible. And we're going to talk about that in just one moment, but first I'm just going to give a quick mention to today's sponsor, Squarespace. I use Squarespace for all of my online needs. I designed my website, I bought my domain, I manage my email list, I manage my online store, all through Squarespace. Their platform is super easy to use. You don't need any experience with web design to create a clean and professional website. Their all-in-one platform also supports scheduling, donations, detailed analytics, and more. If you would like to start a free trial, you can head to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate. You don't have to enter your credit card details or anything to get started. And when you love it and decide to launch, use code healthcoachkate to save 10% off your first order. Thank you again to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Natural treatments. Now, before we get into the one diet adjustment you can make that can help to reverse type 2 diabetes and help to manage type 1, I want to make one thing very clear. Do not make any diet change or adjust any medication without consulting with your doctor first. And the reason that this is so important is that when you change your diet in the way I am about to outline, your need for insulin is going to decrease rapidly. So if you change your diet and do not adjust your injections, no matter if you are type 1 or type 2, this can result in you experiencing low blood sugar or hypoglycemia, which can be just as dangerous as high blood sugar. But anyways, now let's talk about low carb diets and how they can be an effective treatment for diabetes. Let's talk about type 1 first. As I previously mentioned, type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune condition and there's no cure for it. The body is simply not able to create insulin, and so it has to be injected. There's really no way around this. But what an individual can do that will help is reduce their need for insulin. But how can they do that? The answer is by reducing carbohydrates in the diet. Because when we eat foods that contain carbohydrates, these carbs are broken down into glucose, aka sugar, and they enter our bloodstream, causing our blood sugar to rise. The same does not happen when we eat protein and fat, which are broken down into amino acids and fatty acids. So by eating fewer carbs, less insulin is needed, and it can be easier to manage blood sugar. Now, type 1 diabetics will know that diet isn't the only factor that can impact blood sugar, but it is probably the easiest one to control. Most of the studies done on low carbohydrate diets and diabetes are done on people with type 2 diabetes. However, there are a few randomized controlled trials that have been done and shown that carb restriction can be effective for type 1 diabetes as well. One 2019 study had participants eating fewer than 100 grams of carbs a day for 12 weeks, and then they ate over 250 grams of carbs a day for another 12 weeks. During the low carb phase, they had more stable blood sugar levels and had fewer episodes of low blood sugar versus the high carb phase. Not to mention, they lost an average of 5 pounds. As for low-carb diets and type 2 diabetes, there is a lot of evidence supporting it. In one study done on 28 participants with type 2 diabetes who ate a diet aimed at lowering carbs, after 16 weeks, Out of the 28 participants, 7 were able to discontinue medication entirely, and 10 were able to reduce it. The study concluded, because the low-carb ketogenic diet can be very effective at lowering blood glucose, patients on diabetes medication who use this diet should be under close medical supervision or capable of adjusting their medication. And this is what I was talking about before. Low-carb ketogenic diets can be extremely effective for reducing the need for insulin and reversing insulin resistance and type 2 diabetes. Now, if you are not sure how to start a low-carb diet, I have so many videos on the topic. I will link one above if you want to check it out afterwards. And if you are a little bit hesitant about making this diet change, I really encourage you to give it a shot. Because low-carb diets can be extremely powerful, and once you get over the initial learning curve, they can be surprisingly enjoyable and easy to maintain. Anyways, guys, that is all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below if you are a type 1 diabetic, if you're a type 2 diabetic, or maybe you're pre-diabetic. I'm curious to know who is watching my videos. If you did enjoy this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and click that subscribe button if you're not already subscribed. And remember to check out today's sponsor, Squarespace, for all of your online business needs. I will put the link to check them out and start your free trial in the description box down below. And if you did enjoy this video, you might also enjoy my video on how to start a low-carb diet. I will link it here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, I'll put that video right here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, which can also help you get started on a low-carb diet, I will link those here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.